Hey, everybody. How is it going? How are you? Dan Schinder here, Drum Talk TV. I've been missing you. So let's see here. June 12th, we're going to celebrate John Wetton, who would have been 74 today. One of my biggest musical influences. I'm going to take a knee right here for a moment. Last time we were live was, May 20th at the Drum Talk TV 10-year anniversary celebration show in Las Vegas. We had it up for about a week and a half, took it down because we're doing something real special with it. We're reimagining it. We're going to publish probably three of the songs I played with my band from the 70s. And yes, I'm that old. And some nuggets of Jeff Berlin and myself unpacking the Drum Talk TV story and me jamming with Jeff and also A.D. Adams jamming with Jeff. And the whole thing's probably only going to be available in our membership site. But regarding the membership site, it's going to be like no other membership site of any brand in any industry. And it's not just for drummers. It's not just for musicians. It's for all types of music fans. More on that coming out. There's one little promo that squeaks out once in a while. In a week and a half or so, we'll have something that'll give you a peek at the inside of our 3D metaverse. I believe you'll be very impressed. Lots of fun stuff coming, but today is all about John Wetton. So I know that John left us with an incredible body of work, from Family to King Crimson to Uriah Heep to working with Eric Clapton, many other musicians, a ton of session work, Asia, of course, and UK before that. So for the sake of time, as it says in the post, I elected to play just a few tracks. I've only got till 1 o'clock, and then I have to pick up our zoo of five furries from the groomer. And then I have meetings and working on the subscription site. So some Asia from the first album, maybe something from the second, and a couple UK songs. So if you're a fan of John, let us know if you have a favorite piece of music by his or favorite album, if you ever saw him live. And let us know where you're watching from. I'm in Globe, Arizona. Where the is that? I live here and I hardly know. I can barely find my way here. You know, I think something happened to my laptop or something. It's behaving very weirdly. I know I probably am as well. Joshua VP, how are you? So let me get to this. I'm going to bring our show up so I can see comments. Let me know where you're watching from. I'm in Globe, Arizona, which is 100 miles east of Phoenix, up in the mountains. Got little dings and things going off in my, okay, that's one of the other sons sending me drum stuff. Kevon is really into drummers, even though he's a singer. So, let me know where you're watching from. Let me know your favorite piece by John Wetton. And let's get the party started. I'm going to play something first. One of my favorite Asia songs. When I first heard this on the first album, I was absolutely floored. This is live from the reunion years. And I do want to give some shout outs. So comment. It's your show too. Be part of the show. Let's talk about John Wetton. Let's talk about his music. Even if it's not from Asia or UK, which I'm playing today, if you have a favorite from King Crimson, mine's probably Starless. There's plenty of others, right? So let's see. Steven Schinder says, saw someone request Starless, and I think someone else requested The Smile Has Left Your Eyes. So The Smile Has Left Your Eyes, working backwards from producer Steven's comment, of someone else's comment. We try to be as specific as we are, and I know Steve put in the post about this, and so did I. Asia and UK. Starless is not from Asia or UK. So I'm not going to play Starless for the reasons I said. Wonderful song, amazing piece of music, amazing work by John. The Smile Has Left Your Eyes has very little drumming, and I'm probably, I might let that play last. We'll see if it's in the playlist that I have to work off of. Now, I always work off of bootleg versions for reasons that I've said over and over and over, because you can't play to official stuff or it gets flagged. And I might come around and move that camera up just a touch. Not that you need to see the top of my head, but just for a better view. So go ahead and comment. If you have a suggestion, go ahead and let me know how I'm doing once I do play. It might suck, I don't know. But you know what, I don't care. Because for me, it's all about honoring my favorite musicians. You know, that's something that's different about me, and no offense, a lot of other people in our space, is whenever it's a big rock star's birthday, we honor them with their work. Not a picture of me with my arm around them. Look who I know. I don't get that. I don't understand how that's celebrating their birthday. So I did meet John Wetton 1,000 years ago. I met John at the first Asia concert tour in Santa Monica, when they played the Santa Monica Civic. And I met him at Tower Records with the band after the show on Sunset. It was very brief, single file meet and greet across the table where they were all sitting. I should have dug out the pictures. I have photos I took. But yeah, that was really cool. So let's get on with it after I read a couple comments. Hey, Joshua VP. Hey, Dan. Heat wave. So looking forward to some good summer night music. He's in Belgium. Thanks. Favorite piece? Rendezvous 602, probably. Greets from Belgium. Oh, thank you so much. Lou Calderola, my co-host on Under the Influence. It's not what it sounds like. Well, it kind of is with Lou on the show. But anyways, Lou says, cheers, guys. Was only able to check in between lessons today. Sorry, can't stay for the full version. Wetton was amazing. Great stuff, Dan. No worries. This will archive, so you can watch it when you have time. Make some popcorn, everybody. But stay with me now if you're able to. And I'm going to play Wildest Dreams. I just absolutely love this song. This is from New Jersey 2011. I have not played drums since. No, that's not true. I was going to say I haven't played since May 20th, the Drum Talk TV show. But two nights ago, I played at an open mic celebration for a friend of mine who passed away in town, who ran the open mic after my wife and I stopped doing our open mic here. And anyways, I've played a little bit. So let's see what happens, just for fun. And I do this, why do I walk that tightrope? To encourage others to have fun playing. Hopefully it won't be blown out. All right, Wildest Dreams without glasses, here we go. one more on that live version. That's funny. So there you go, Wildest Dreams. Wildest Dreams from the 2011 Reunion Years Tour is what that was. Let me just step back one here. All right, catching my breath here. Gonna have a drink of some refrigerated tea, which is weird. I know. I guess it's like iced tea, but I buy tension tamer tea. I don't know why my wife says I need tension tamer tea. I'm not sure what's up with that. So what do you hydrate with when you play if you're a musician? And if you say whiskey or bourbon, I don't think that's hydrating. Let me know where you're watching from. As I mentioned earlier, see if we have any more comments, suggestions, or anything. Oh, thank you, Stephen. The book. I'm going to talk about the book for a moment. Steve and I, my son Stephen, producer Stephen Schindler, we do a show called Yes Shift. It's a Prague-based show, pretty much covers Yes, but a lot of the periphery, and John Wetton certainly falls into that, being a member of Asia and King Crimson. And we had the honor of reviewing the book before it comes out on sale, called An Extraordinary Life. And wow, what an extraordinary life indeed, and a great, great book. Great book. Another one coming up soon is The Tormato Years, The Tormato Story, sorry, about Yes, and Steve and I are getting ready to review that as well. That book is out, and it's a great, great book. So cool. Here we go with a little bit more Asia. Happy birthday in heaven, John. I'm sure you're finding plenty of blokes to jam with up there. So let's see. Let's move on to, and I'll watch for suggestions. How about Time Again? I actually covered this song on a CD years ago, 1998. Or in 99, I did some classic rock songs in big band style. So let's see how this one is. This is audience shot as well on a phone. I think the audio would be good enough for me to hear. I don't know why I have hearing issues. Been playing for 54 years, married. We have 5 furries in the house, and between my wife and I, we have 11 kids and 19 grandkids. I don't know why I have hearing issues, but sometimes bootlegs do not have the best audio, and it is hard to hear. So hopefully we picked out some good ones that'll make sense. This is Time Again. Chime in for John Wetton, please. I take it, since no one's complaining, the audio is okay to some degree at least. We'll see after this song. We'll be right back. that would happen. I don't have my my stick bag because usually I have my stick bag right to the left of me hanging on my one of my two timpani drums right here. I don't have it because I mentioned earlier a friend of mine passed away in town the other day, and a mutual friend who I jam with called me and said, hey, the mortuary said we could have a band tonight for Michael's viewing. I said, wait, what? Or he said this the other day. And so I'm bringing my small jazz kit and I have my stick bag packed with that. So I had to pick a stick up off the floor. Anyhow, playing for John Wetton, one of my biggest musical influences. Go ahead and chime in with a favorite John song if you have one. And we will continue with, I'm doing like a handful. Here's another Asia one that I'd like to play. This is called, did I mention that Carl Palmer is also an influence? I guess that would be worth mentioning. Carl's been on the show two or three times. So we're gonna do Soul Survivor. And I don't know how this version ends because it fades out on the album, so I might just fade out or something. But yeah, let's do this, and then I'll do one or two UK songs. And thanks for hanging out with me. Sign up for our newsletter. We have big announcements coming for our membership site, which is going to be amazing, I promise. There's a little video out there now, but it doesn't show anything. There's going to be a video coming out soon that'll show some of our 3D metaverse. And this membership site is for music fans. It's not just for drummers. It's not even just for musicians. Also coming out soon are some videos and a photo album from our 10-year celebration show that we did May 20th in Las Vegas. Meanwhile, Soul Survivor.
So a survivor. We'll be right back.
the forever fade. As it goes on the album, glasses, where are my glasses? I can't see anything. So again, those of you just joining us, you probably see it in the text of the post, where we're celebrating a little bit of music from the late, great John Wetton. Would have been 74 today on June 12th. That's also my granddaughter Skye's birthday. Happy birthday, Skye. One of 19. Oh, that's trippy. How do I have 19 grandkids? Let's see. Hey, Larry Albertson is here. Thank you for chiming in. So let's see, do I have Rendezvous 602? Let me see, I think it's on what you sent me, Steve, but I might do one other UK song first. Let me take a look here. I'll never forget the impression UK made on me when I first heard that first album with Bill Bruford, Alan Holdsworth, John Wetton, and Eddie Jobson. What a crazy ass lineup, right? Come on, what's going on with this? I think I need a new laptop. These buttons don't work here. Okay, is Rendezvous 602 on here? It's not. It might be on the other one. So let's do this instead for now, and then I'll see if I can find it. I forgot what song this is that I'm going to play. Oh, I think it's In the Dead of Night, the Bill Bruford version, as opposed to with Eddie Jobson, as opposed to with Terry Bozzio playing it on the second tour, which I saw them open for Jethro Tull on that. So here we go. Let me go back to comments first. Cool. Thanks, Larry. Skye. One of Skye's watching Grandpa. All right, here we go with, pretty sure I have it queued up to In the Dead of Night. The audio's okay? Is it crunchy or mushy? I'm getting a whole new setup in the studio this year, by the way. Get the Bill Bruford snare going. You were here. I wouldn't forget that. All right, here we go. This bell is still ringing from two songs ago. All right. I'll check comments after. Thank you. out. That sounds weird. Hold on. I thought it felt weird. Hold on. All right. Over my tea, good thing there's a cap on it. Like I said earlier, if and chime in. What's up with the silence, the radio silence? Chime in. If you're a musician or a concert goer and you hydrate when you're doing that stuff, what do you hydrate with? And Jack Daniels whiskey or bourbon or Jim Beam or whatever, it does not count. Oh, I have a microphone stand. Let me use it. Come on, get in there. Right. Now, let's see if I could find Rendezvous 602 as a bootleg, since it's been requested a few times, I believe. Is that right, Steve? Okay. Let's see. How is everyone? How is your world? I'm going to look up Rendezvous 602. Any other Asia or UK? Thanks, Steve. Okay, thanks. I can definitely be louder when I speak. All right. I'm going to switch to another screen so I can look for Rendezvous. I was in a band called Rendezvous a million years ago. Almost there, folks. I don't know if this is a bootleg or not. Let's see. Bear with me here. I may have found it. Bear with me. If you have another suggestion, I am open to it. See if it's on this one. Thanks for your patience. If you've seen anything interesting on Drum Talk TV that you like and want to give a shout out to, I would love to know that from you. Okay, it's not on this one. How about this one? Bear with me, I'm looking for it, folks. Oh, wow. There's no, oh, you know what? I may have found it. You know what? If I can't find it now, I will weave it into another show. Because this is not timestamped. It's a crappy recording, too. Yeah, I'm sorry. I can't find it real quickly, and I don't want to hold stuff up. So, Bert Good Jr. a million years ago. Almost. I mean, I rounded up just a little bit a million years ago. Yeah. So when was that? That was, that was Cola Zero. Oh, yeah. But that's not UK or Asia. I'm only just doing UK or Asia. I wish I could find Rendezvous 602 really quickly. I haven't found a good version to play to, but I'll weave it into another live. But yeah, I was in a band called Rendezvous with Becky LeBeau and Steve Weinberg and Jeff. Can't remember Jeff's last name because he never told us till like the end of the band. Long story. That was 1980. Oh, it's after I broke my I auditioned with a broken arm. So that would have been 81, summer of 81. Yeah, it's not quite a million years ago, but it feels like it. And now that I'm have entered my 60s, which is really, Cola Zero is a drink, not a band. I thought you meant a song by John Wetton that maybe I didn't know about. Thanks, Joshua. And I just got a text from my wife that all of our 5 furry babies are ready to be picked up from the groomer. And I got a day of meetings and working on our membership site sign up for our email list so you can get on board early and help us develop it with telling us what you like, what you don't like, what's easy to navigate, what needs to be tweaked, and some suggestions. Be a part of the experience of putting the experience together. It's in a 3D metaverse. I'll come around because I got to turn off the camera. Lots of neat stuff coming with that. I want to thank you so much for following Drum Talk TV, and also for, I gotta answer the boss real quick. Also for just following what we do and joining me right now. Okay, be there in a sec. I don't think I've done that during a show. Many of you may know my wife, Enja. Steve Schindler, I wanna thank very much, our behind the scenes producer for live broadcasts of all types. And just do me a favor and please sign up for our email list. We're the opposite of most email lists. We do not bombard with emails too frequently. I don't even send them out enough. And I'm the one that does it personally. But we have some exciting things coming for you to be a part of. A whole new experience for music fans, not just drummers or musicians, music fans in a 3D metaverse coming beginning of August. Sign up, be part of the development. We care what you think, believe it or not. Thank you.